Hey everyone, Dr. Notley here. One of the most common questions that I get asked by my patients is it okay to crack your knuckles? One of the old wives' tales is that you crack your knuckles a lot, you end up having arthritis. So I decided to go and look at the research and see what it actually says. In 1975, they looked at 28 people, and about half of them were knuckle crackers and the other half weren't. And they did x-rays to see if there was a difference in arthritis between the groups. And they found that there was no difference. And one of the things they did say is that the chief morbid consequence of knuckle cracking would appear to be its annoying effect on the observer. So obviously, people don't like hearing that knuckle cracking sound. In 1990, 300 people were studied, 74 of which were chronic knuckle crackers, and 226 were non-knuckle crackers. 64% of those knuckle crackers actually had an increase in swelling in their hands, and they also had a grip strength that was significantly less than non-crackers. When comparing signs of arthritis, which are swellings in and around the knuckles, they actually found that it was similar. Interesting to note with this, the knuckle cracking group is that they were often manual laborers. They had higher incomes. They smoked frequently, drank alcohol, and bit their nails. Could these be factors that may influence strength and swelling? I don't know. In 2011, there was a survey study that was performed, and they had 215 surveys that came back. And what they found was that there was no difference between non-crackers and those that cracked a lot when it came to the degrees of arthritis that they had. And also, they found that there was no connection between being a manual laborer that was seen in the previous study. In 2017, there was a study done where they looked at the quick dash score, which is a questionnaire that looks at the amount of disability of the arm, shoulder, hand. And they also looked at swelling of the hand, weakness, joint laxity, and range of motion between knuckle crackers and non-knuckle crackers. And what they found that there was no difference with the quick dash score. There was no difference between laxity and grip strength. When comparing range of motion, though, there's a slight increase in range of motion in chronic knuckle crackers. In 2017, there was a different study done. They did look at strength of the knuckle crackers, but they also looked at the thickness of the cartilage within the joints. And what they found was grip strength was the same, but in chronic knuckle crackers, the thickness of the cartilage was thicker. And there is some indication that an increased thickness in the cartilage is actually an indication of edema, swelling within the cartilage, which may be an early sign of arthritis. So right now in the research, we're not quite seeing that there's this huge difference between arthritis and no arthritis with those that have cracked their knuckles, but there may be some indication that there might be some damage.